Hi everyone, welcome back to Web the Channel. My name is Zach, and in this video we're looking at Stephen Colbert talking about NFTs on his show. He has spoken about NFTs before. He has been incredibly unhelpful and misguided and in general dangerous, I think, to people watching who don't know anything about NFTs, simply putting out a lot of misinformation. But this time around, there's a slight silver lining that I want to go over in this video. And so we're going to play the video right now and listen to what he has to say.
Regular viewers may remember a few months ago, I explained to America what NFTs, or non-fungible tokens, are. In short, you see a digital thingamabob that you want to buy, like a picture or a song. Then you purchase it using online cryptocurrency. Then your proof of purchase is stored on a secure digital ledger called a blockchain. Then you explain to your wife that you can't go to Hawaii this year because you bought a picture of a bored monkey. And NFT auctions can raise some serious coin. An NFT picture of...
To be clear, when it comes to like jokes about putting a lot of money on a monkey, that stuff I don't necessarily find to be an issue. Like, that's kind of funny. Like, yeah, it's funny.
The cape John Lennon wore in the movie Help just went for $12,800. Because when John Lennon sang Imagine No Possessions, he could never have anticipated the thrill of owning an avatar of manufactured scarcity on an encoded blockchain. Well, at the end of explaining all this on the show to you last year, I wrote out my explanation of NFTs on a paper bag that my lunch came in that day, so that we could offer that bag for auction as what I called an AFT, or actual thing. Well,
see, what's interesting is, right, is that this man's dunking on NFTs, or at least it comes across that way. But what you're about to learn is that they're actually going to be using NFTs for something useful.
Well, the auction has closed, and I'm happy to announce it raised some actual money, namely over $33,000. To Rich's story. And I am proud to announce that 100% of all that,
you know what's crazy,
that money
is how the crowd will celebrate. And this is perfect. It just shows how stupid people are sometimes. People are celebrating a paper bag selling for 33K. Right? And there's no like benefit that we know right now. All we know is that it's 33K. And yet, we're talking about a paper bag that actually doesn't have any smart contracts. I can't even believe I'm having to say that. All this stuff, right, and people are applauding a paper bag. But when it comes to an NFT that actually provides some level of use case, no, that's bad. You can't do something that's bad for the environment, but you can sell a paper bag. That's great.
Went directly to Donors Choose, where it has already helped fund classroom projects across the country, like building solar ovens and hydroponic systems, actual things.
So, up until now, Stephen Colbert absolutely gets this totally fundamentally wrong. And I honestly wish that to a certain extent, when it comes to misinformation, that there were defamation lawsuits on some people for this stuff. Because it's just strictly terribly uneducated, misinforming. And it's not just a case of being misinformed, it's a case of broadcasting that dumb bullshit to the rest of the world. Anyway.
Donors Choose is doing so much good work, experts say they could bring our school system to the brink of functioning. And now, I'm happy to present to you an update to our update, because another company is hopping on my donation train. The UK metaverse marketplace Terra Virtua has designed a very special NFT to support Donors Choose. And here he is. It's an NFT of me holding my AFT that explains NFTs. This little fella is called the Colbert V-Flect. There will be a limited run of them available, and you can buy your own unique Colbert V-Flect NFT to put in your TikToks and your Instafaces and your Ugrams.
Right, so let me just get this straight. In the same 3 minutes, this man has managed to completely clown NFTs whilst also making use of them to, and you'll see this in a minute, to go to charity.
And he's pretty easy to care for. Just once a day, spritz your laptop with a little bourbon. Here's the best part. It's all hosted on the climate-sustainable blockchain Polygon, which they say is 99.99% more carbon efficient than Ethereum, which I believe runs on ground-up panda bones. And to get yours, go to terravirtua.io/Colbert. Terra Virtua is donating 100% of the proceeds to Donors Choose.
Okay, so just to get this straight, we're going to climb on NFTs for, you know, whatever, and then we're going to go over and say, actually, you can now buy NFTs, put a link in the show down below, and it will go to charity. So it's just a really mixed message to me. Now, realistically, of course, he's meant to be a comedian. I get it, right? But I think when it comes to this stuff, when it comes to real life stuff, it's way too easy to simply just go with misinformation and spread that to people, because people don't even know what's happening at this point, I'm sure. Like, at first he's clowning on them, then he's saying that, you know, I have an AFT, then he's saying that we have an NFT that can be sold to, you know, help with schools nationwide, which is a brilliant cause. And then talking about, it's just so dumb. Like, if educate, if you're going to educate, just educate. Stop putting out bullshit jokes that actually aren't funny in any way. I know they're laughing, it's because they're laughing. They're laughing because they're so misinformed because of the mainstream media narrative on this stuff. I bet people are thinking, what the hell is he doing? Why is he now shilling NFTs? And yet, he somehow managed to piss off both groups, I feel like. He'll have managed to piss off people who hate NFTs, and he's pissed off people who like NFTs. I don't know how you managed to do something so stupid.
So you can feel good about helping kids. Hell yeah, why not? Why not?
Now, realistically, my guess is that maybe he doesn't write his own jokes, and, you know, and maybe he's just being told to say shit. I don't know. Maybe he doesn't even know what the hell he's talking about. I have no idea where he is with this stuff. But realistically, you can't blame me when he doesn't really put out any actual information. That being said, what are your thoughts? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear your take. That being said, this is the Weather Channel. Covering everything happening from crypto, NFT, Metaverse news. Have a great day, everyone. I'll see you in the next Web3 video.